Welcome to another VMblog Work From Home series. Today we have the pleasure of having Nico Zieck, who is the Senior IT Architect for Liquit with us. How are you doing today?
I'm doing great. Good weather in Netherlands, so happy to be here.
Maybe you can start by just giving us a short background of the company itself.
Liquit is a Dutch-based software vendor, founded in 2015, and we're focusing on delivering the unified workspace to the end user. So enabling users to do their work from home or anywhere around the world as easy as possible.
And we've kind of been talking a little bit ahead of time about the pandemic. So, you know, keeping with that theme, the pandemic is a major topic these days. How has it changed the way, you know, companies are dealing with their employees? And are you hearing from your own customers? Were they caught by surprise, or did they already have solutions in place to help make the shift from the office to work from home?
Well, I think it's a pretty good question. So I think generally we can separate two types of customers. So the old school customers, so the people who got their employees to go to the work off and the office every day, so to keep some certain way of control over their users, over their employees. Now you have the other part that's already working in real flexible ways. So usually that are the typical Liquit customers already in place. So they had a focus on a more modern workspace, working from home. And we see that a lot in the Netherlands. So in the Netherlands didn't change a lot of things. So we have a good infrastructure, and by law you have to you are allowed to work from home. So it's by law. Looking at our other customers, you see a lot of people just working in the office from day to day basis, keep some sort of control. Now you see that the companies need to give them the trust and the freedom to do their own work at from home, and you see things will shift into different working style. So people get more, feel more freedom, so they feel more power to do things for the company because they feel more happy.
And for the companies that are continuing to push forward to this new work from home model, before we go into the technology side of things, in general, how is this affecting the people, the connectivity, and the infrastructure behind it?
So if I'm looking at myself, working from home, I just love it. And I think a lot of our customers love it, going out of bed, just doing my work. The thing I miss is the connectivity and the talking to my colleagues. So the most thing I want to have is somewhere in between. So working from home and from time to time being in my office. So what it has to do for the technology, you got to have a good at-home workspace. So a good device, good internet connection, of course. But then something that will enable you to access your information data and also do your Zoom meetings or your Microsoft Teams meetings in the correct fashion. So it's affecting people in a lot of different ways. First of all, the communication. I simply just miss it on a day-to-day basis. And that's all I hear from my colleagues, but also from our customers. We miss the office. So the office is still important, but we love to work from home. And we are really more productive working from home, no more traveling. So things are changing. And yeah, on a technical point of view, you need a different solution. So you just can't use your old-fashioned laptop in the office. You need more stuff.
And so how does Liquit Solutions help enable work from home?
So Liquit is actually a smart workplace. So what we do, we aggregate a variety of services like Citrix, WVD, but also local applications. And the user will simply just see an icon. And Liquit will decide based on where the user is, based on the user's peripheral devices, and based on other specifications, what should be launched in a certain scenario. So the IT admin has full control of what will happen where and when, but the end user simply just clicks on application, so he doesn't have to think about it, and therefore the IT is more accessible for the end users, make it more simple.
So what are some of the big questions that your customers are asking as they're transitioning to work from home?
So we've got a lot of questions. So a lot of customers that we have are running out of power on their virtualization platform. So they use the virtualization platform for a limited amount of users. Now, of course, everybody's working from home. They're going to stress those virtual environments. So they need to spin up some extra machines. So Liquit is able to help you with it, or add another system to it like WVD just for a burst mode, just for a short period of time, add extra machines and manage those machines. And so our customers are requesting, how can we make things more easy for end users? Because now in the office, everybody knows where I have to be. Where's my printer? How do you do that from home? When I log on, what will happen to my phone? What will happen to my productivity applications? How do I access the data? How do I secure the data? So Liquit gets all these questions every day again, And basically that's where Liquit was founded on, making the workspace smoother, faster, and better for the end user without the user having to think about it.
And security is always something that's top of mind, or should be for most companies. You know, with this whole work shift from the office to working from home, are there any special things that companies should be paying attention to?
Yeah, of course, data. It's all about the data. So what do you do with the data when a user is using his own device? Where do you save it? Do you remove it? Do you allow to save those data on that local device? That's something a system administrator have to think about it. So we offer context awareness. So in corporate-owned devices, we are allowing users to run and store their own local data. But if it's not corporate-owned and you're working from home, we don't allow it to run your data, for instance, on your local device, and then you will be redirected to a Citrix session, which will be secured. So of course, data is really important. Then the other part is the security of the connection. It's also really important. How do you keep unwanted people out of your network? How do you manage all those network connections into your data center? So something we're not focusing on, but just helping the IT admins to keep control over those processes.
And you know, what are some of the key technologies that people are using in this work from home?
So basically we see a major upcoming in the Office 365 usage, but we see more and more people going into Microsoft 365. Of course, today is only one name, but I still separate Office 365 from Microsoft 365. So we see a lot of our customers going into Microsoft 365, remote deploying their devices with Autopilot, and then offering them a true hybrid environment, separating some local applications to save some resources on the virtual environment, and for special applications or high security applications, deliver a virtual environment like a VDI or an SBC or a ZenApp session, for instance. So it's for productivity, the Office Suite, Office 365, for communication, or most commonly Zoom or Team or something, and for deployment, you see a shift from in office deployment, then just shipping out your device to an end user, let the device be enrolled itself, and then let Liquit do all the deployment, and we broker you into secure applications on Citrix or VMware. So those are the most common use technologies for us.
And, you know, we talked about this off camera before, but, you know, there's a lot of companies are starting to move back now, bringing their people back from home back into the office. Are there any tips that you can share that companies should be doing now to prepare for, you know, another event like this?
I think it should be much broader. So I think everybody has seen the success of working from home. So if I'm looking just typically at the Netherlands, the economic just went on. It didn't stop anything. So we were prepared for something from working from home. If I can suggest for every company, just focus from working from home, allow your people to work from home. So you always be prepared for something like this. Let the people get used to it. You're already used to it. Why don't use it? So you don't need that much office space. You already have a lot of resources in place. Just focus on it, take it on your roadmap, and go from that point on. But I really strongly encourage all companies, just keep it this way. Focus on it and allow your people to get more freedom. Trust your employees with it.
So obviously it sounds like the best strategy is to be prepared for work from home and have that as your normal policy. For people that do want to come back into the office, you know, how do you get them to come back? And what are the cost savings for keeping people working remotely?
So I've read some research that productivity of much of people. Yesterday I talked about to a customer, the productivity of the typical employee raised by 30% by working from home. So instead of traveling. So how do you get them back in the office? Well, first of all, if they're happy to work from home, keep it that way. In Europe, we see a lot of companies just allowing people to work from home every day. But I think workspace is something like a social place. You want to see your colleagues, just you want to see your friends. It's all about personal communication from that point. So I think workplace should be, the office should be a place where people feel happy. So like good coffee, for instance, but also good IT. But I think it's going to be in a hybrid way. So hybrid IT tech, but also hybrid workspace. So working from home should always be there. And if people are happy, they'll be more productive. So for me, myself, what I see, I tend to work a little bit more off hours if necessary, because I'm happy. I can do my shopping during daytime. So I feel much more happy, feel much more enabled with my family. So I'm much more home. So I'm happier to do my work.
Well, before we let you go, I want to ask, you know, where can viewers go if they want to learn more about the company and the technology? And do you have any resources online that specifically addresses the work from home topic that we're talking about today?
Yeah, of course, they can go to our website, liquit.com, where they can request a full live demo. Of course, it's free free of charge, so you can use it for a time of period you want. Of course, we will contact you afterwards. But you also can look up some of our videos we've posted and our solution brief at Microsoft for the WVD part. So Liquit is a WVD partner. We show you exactly how things can work with our smart icons and what will be done to work from home, how to enable it.
Well, great. Well, thanks again. We appreciate you taking time to speak to VMblog today.
You're welcome. Thank you very much for the time.
I hope you enjoyed this video. If you'd like to see more of these VMblog videos, please hit the like button and subscribe. And it's important, if you want to get notified the next time we post a video, please hit the subscribe and the bell notification.